Good evening, and continuing my reading from the book, the first book of Samuel of the Holy Bible, the Old Testament actually, the first book of Samuel, chapter 17 onwards. Now the Philistines gathered together the armies of battle and were gathered together at Shoco, which belonged to Judah, and pitched between Shoco and Azekah in Ephes-Damin. And Saul and the men of Israel were gathered together and pitched by the valley of Elah, and set the battle in array against the Philistines. And the Philistines stood on a mountain on one side, and Israel stood on a mountain on the other side. And there was a valley between them. And there was a champion out of the camp of Philistines named Goliath of Gath, whose height was 6 cubits and a span. And he had a helmet of brass upon his head, and he was armed with a coat of mail. And the weight of the coat was 5,000 shekels of brass. And he had greaves of brass upon his leg, and target of brass between his shoulders. And the staff of his spear was like a weaver's beam, and the spear's head weighed 600 shekels of iron, and one bearing a shield went before him. And he stood and cried unto the armies of Israel, and said unto them, Why are ye come out to set your battle in array? Am I not a Philistine, and ye servants to Saul? Choose you a man for you, and let him come down unto me. For if he be able to fight me and to kill me, then will we be your servants. But if I prevail against him and kill him, then you shall be our servants and servers. And the Philistine said, I will defy the armies of Israel this day. Give me a man that we may fight together. When Saul and all Israel heard those words of the Philistine and were dismayed and greatly afraid, David the son of the Ephrathite of Bethlehem, Judah, whose name was Jesse, and he had 8 sons, and the man went among for an old man in the days of Saul. And the 3 eldest sons of Jesse went and followed Saul to the battle. And the names of the 3 sons that went to the battle were Eliab, the firstborn unto him Abinadab, and the 3rd Shammah. And David was the youngest, and the 3 eldest followed Saul. And David went and returned from Saul to feed his father's sheep at Bethlehem. And the Philistine drew near morning and evening, and presented himself 40 days. And Jesse said unto David his son, Take now for his brethren an ephah of parched corn, and take these loaves, and run to the camp of the brethren, and carry the 10 cheeses unto the captain of the 1,000, and look how the brethren fare, and take their pledge. Now Saul and they and all the men of Israel were in the valley of Elah, fighting with the Philistines. And David rose early morning, and was left the sheep with the keeper, and took and went, as Jesse had commanded him. And he came to the trench as the host, going forth to fight, and shouted for the battle. For Israel and the Philistines had put the battle in array, army against army. And David left his carriage in the hand of the keeper of the carriage, and ran into the army, and came and saluted his brethren. And as he talked with them, behold, there came up the champion, the Philistine of Gath, Goliath by name. And out of the armies of the Philistines spake according to the same words, and David heard them. And all the men of Israel, when they saw the man, fled from him, and were sore afraid. And the men of Israel said, Have ye seen this man that is come up? Surely to defy Israel is he come up. And it shall be that the man who killeth him and the kill will enrich him with great riches, and will give him his daughter, and make his house father's house free in Israel. And David spake to the men that stood by him, saying, What shall be done to the man that killeth this Philistine, and taketh away the reproach from Israel? For who is this uncircumcised Philistine, that he should defy the armies of the living God? And the people answered him from after this manner, saying, So shall it be done to the man that killeth him. And Eliab, his eldest brother, heard when he spake unto the men. And Eliab's anger was kindled against David, and he said, Why camest thou hither? And with whom hast thou left those few sheep in the wilderness? I know thy pride, the naughtiness of thy heart, for thou art come down that thou must see the battle. And David said, What have I done now? Is there not a cause? And he turned from him toward another, and spake after the same manner. And the people answered him again after the former manner. And when the words were heard which David spoke, they rehearsed them before Saul, and he sent for him. And David said to Saul, Let no man's heart fail because of him. Thy servant will go and fight with this Philistine. And Saul said to David, Thou art not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for thou art but a youth, and he is a man of war from his youth. And David said unto Saul, Thy servant kept his father's sheep, and there came a lion and a bear, and took a lamb out of the flock. And I went out after him, and smote him, delivered it out of his mouth. And when he arose against me, I caught him by the beard and smote him and slew him. And the servant slew both the lion and bear. And this uncircumcised Philistine shall be as one of them, seeing he has defiled the armies of the living God. David said, moreover, the Lord that delivered me out of the paw of the lion and out of the paw of the bear, he will deliver me out of the hand of the Philistine. And Saul said unto David, go, and the Lord be with thee. And Saul armed David with his armor, and he put a helmet of brass upon his head. Also he armed him with a coat of mail. And David girded his sword upon his armor, and he essayed to go, for he had not proved it. And David said unto Saul, I cannot go with these, for I have not proved it. And David put them off. And he took in his staff in his hand, and chose him 5 smooth stones out of the brook, and put them in a shepherd's bag, which he had, even in his scrip. And the sling was in his hand, and he drew near to the Philistine. And the Philistine came, and drew near to David. And the man that bare the shield went before him. And when the Philistine looked about and saw David, he disdained him, for he was but a youth and ruddy, and of fair countenance. And the Philistine said unto David, am I a dog that thou comest to me with staves? And the Philistines cursed David by his gods. And the Philistines said to David, come to me, I will give thy flesh unto the fowls of the air and to the beasts of the field. And David said to the Philistine, thou comest to me with a sword and with a spear and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defied. This day will the Lord deliver thee into my hand. I will smite thee, take the head from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the host of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air and the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel. And all this assembly shall know that the Lord saveth not with sword and spear, for the Lord, the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into our hands. And it came to pass, when the Philistine arose and came and drew nigh to meet David, David hasted, ran toward the army to meet the Philistine. And David put his hand in a bag, took the stone, slung it, smote the Philistine in the forehead. The stone sunk into his forehead. He fell upon his face to the earth. And David prevailed over the Philistine with a sling and a stone, and smote the Philistine and slew him. But there was no sword in the hand of David. So therefore David ran and stood upon the Philistine, took his sword, drew it out of the sheath, slew him, cut off his head therewith. And when the Philistines saw the champion was dead, they fled. And the men of Israel and Judah arose and shouted, pursued the Philistines, until they came to the valley and to the gates of Ekron. And the wounded of the Philistines fell down by the way of Sharaim, even unto Gath and unto Ekron. And the children of Israel returned from chasing after the Philistines, and they spoiled their tents. And David took the head of the Philistines, brought it to Jerusalem, but he put his armor in his tent. And when Saul saw David go forth against the Philistine, he said to Abner, the captain of the host, Abner, whose son is this youth? And Abner said, as a soul liveth, O king, I cannot tell. And the king said, inquire thou whose son the stripling is. And as David returned from the slaughter of the Philistine, Abner took him and brought him before Saul, with the head of the Philistine in his hand. And Saul said unto him, whose son art thou, young man? And David answered, I am the son of the servant Jesse, the Bethlehemite. Chapter 18. And when it came to pass, when he had made an end of speaking to Saul, that the Saul of Jonathan was knit with the Saul of David, and Jonathan loved him as his own soul. And Saul took him that day and would not let him go no more to his father's house. Then David and Jonathan made a covenant, because he loved him as his own soul. And David stripped himself of the robe that was upon him, and gave it to David. Jonathan stripped himself of the robe that was upon him, and gave it to David, and his garments, and even to his sword, and to his bow, and to his girdle. And David went with Saul. Saul sent him, and behaved himself wisely. And Saul set him over the men of war, and he was accepted in the sight of all the people, and also in the sight of Saul's servants. And it came to pass, as the king, when David was returned from the slaughter of the Philistine, that the women came out of all Israel singing and dancing to meet King Saul, with tabrets, with joy, with instruments of music. And the women answered one another as they played, and said, Saul has slain his thousands, and David his 10,000s. And Saul was very wroth, and the saying displeased him, and he said, They have ascribed unto David 10,000, and to me they have ascribed it thousands. What can he have more but the kingdom? And Saul eyed David from that day and forward. And it came to pass on the morrow that the evil spirit from the God came upon Saul, and he prophesied in the midst of the house. And David played with his hand, as at other times. And there was a javelin in Saul's hand, and he cast his javelin. For he said, I will smite David even to the wall with it. And David avoided out of his presence twice. And Saul was afraid of David, because the Lord was with him, and departed from Saul. Then Saul removed him from him, and made him captain over 1,000. And he went out and came in before his people. And David behaved himself wisely in all his ways, and the Lord was with him. Therefore, when Saul saw that he had behaved himself very wisely, he was afraid of him. But all Israel and Judah loved David, because he went and came in before them. And Saul said unto David, Behold, my elder daughter Merab, her I will give to thee for wife. Only be thou valiant for me, and fight the Lord's battles. And Saul said, Let not my hand be upon him, but let the hand of the Philistines be upon him. And David said unto Saul, Who am I, and what is my life, or my father's family in Israel, that I should be the son-in-law to the king? But it came to pass at that time, when Merab, Saul's daughter, should have been given to David, she was given to Adriel the Meholathite to wife. And Michael, the son, Saul's daughter, loved David, and they said to Saul, and the thing pleased him. And he said, I will give him her, and she may be a snare to him, and that the hand of the Philistines may be against him. Wherefore Saul said to David, Thou shalt this day be my son-in-law in one of the twain. And Saul commanded his servants, saying, Commune with David secretly, and say, Behold, the king has delight in thee, and all his servants love thee. Now therefore be the king's son-in-law. And Saul's servants spake these words unto the ears of David. And David said, Seemeth it a light thing to be a king's son-in-law, seeing that I am a poor man and lightly esteemed? And the servants of Saul told him of the manner spake David. And he said, Tell this unto David, the king desireth not any dowry, but 100 foreskins of the Philistines to be avenged of the king's enemy. But Saul thought to make David fall by the hand of the Philistines. And when the servants told David these words, pleased David well to be the king's son-in-law, and the days were not expired. And David arose and went, he and his men, slew the Philistines 200 men. And David brought the foreskins, and gave them to the in full tale to the king, that he might be the king's son-in-law. And Saul gave Michal, his daughter, to wife. And Saul saw and knew that the Lord was with David, and that Michal, Saul's daughter, loved him. And Saul was yet more afraid of David, and Saul became David's enemy continually. Then the princes of the Philistines went forth, and David behaved himself more wisely than all the servants of Saul, so that his name was much set by. Chapter 90. Then Saul spake unto Jonathan his son, and to all his servants, that they should kill David. And Jonathan, Saul's son, delighted much in David. And Jonathan told David, saying, Saul, my father, seeketh to kill thee. Now therefore, I pray thee, take heed to thyself until the morning, and abide in a secret place, and hide thyself. And I will go out and stand by my father in the field where thou art, and I will commune with the father of thee, and what I see, that I will tell thee. And Jonathan spake good of David unto Saul his father, and said unto him, Let not the king sin against his servant, against David, because he has not sinned against thee, because his works have been to thee word very good. And he did put his life in your hand, and slew the Philistine, and the Lord wrought a great salvation for Israel. Thou sawest it, and didst rejoice. Wherefore then wilt thou sin against innocent blood, to slay David without a cause? And Saul hearkened unto the voice of Jonathan, and Saul sware, and the Lord liveth, he shall not be slain. And Jonathan said unto David, and Jonathan showed him all those things. And Jonathan brought David to Saul, and he was in his presence as in times past. And there was war again, and David went out, fought with Philistines, slew them with great slaughter, and they fled from him. And an evil spirit from the Lord was upon Saul, and he sat in the house with a javelin in his hand, and David played with his hand. And Saul sought to smite David even to the wall with the javelin. But he slipped away out of Saul's presence, and he smote the javelin into the wall. And David fled and escaped that night. Saul also sent messengers unto David's house to watch him, slay him in the morning. And Michal, David's wife, told him, saying, If thou savest not thy life tonight, tomorrow thou shalt be slain. And Michael let David down through a window, and he fled and escaped. And Michael took an image and laid it in the bed, put a pillow of goat's hair for the bolster, covered it with cloth. And when Saul sent messengers to take David, she said, "He is sick." And Saul sent messengers again to see David, "Bring him up to me in the bed, that I may slay him." Messengers were coming, behold, there was an image in the bed, with a pillow of goat's hair for his bolster. And Saul said unto Michael, "Why hast thou deceived me so? Send away mine enemy, that he escape." And Michael answered Saul, "He said unto me, let me go. Why should I kill thee?" And David fled, and escaped, and came to Samuel to Ramah, and told him all that Saul had done unto him. And Samuel went and dwelt in Naioth. And it was told to Saul, saying, "Behold, David is at Naioth in Ramah." And Saul sent messengers to take David. And when they saw the company of the prophets prophesying, and Samuel standing as they appointed over them, the Spirit of God was upon the messengers of Saul, and they also prophesied. When it was told Saul, he sent other messengers, they prophesied likewise. And Saul sent messengers again the third time, they also prophesied likewise. And he also went to Ramah, and came to a great well that is in Sikkim, and asked and said, "Where are Samuel and David?" And one said, "Be there at Naioth in Ramah." And went thither to Naioth in Ramah, the Spirit of God was upon him also. And he went on and prophesied until he came to Naioth in Ramah. And he stripped off his clothes also, and prophesied before Samuel in like manner, and lay down naked all day and all night. Wherefore they say, is Saul also among the prophets. Chapter 20. And David fled from Naioth in Ramah, and came and said before Jonathan, "What have I done? What is my iniquity? And what is my sin before thy father, that he seeketh my life?" And he said unto him, "God forbid, thou shalt not die. Behold, my father will do nothing, either great or small, but he will show it to me. And why should my father hide this thing from me? It is not so." And David sware moreover and said, "Thy father certainly knoweth that I found grace in thy eyes." And he saith, "Let not Jonathan know this, lest he be grieved. But truly, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, there is but a step between me and death." Then said Jonathan to David, "Whatsoever thou desireth, I will do unto thee." And David said to Jonathan, "Behold, tomorrow is a new moon, and I shall not fail to sit with the king at meat. But let me go, that I may hide myself in the field unto the third day at even. If thy father at all miss me, and then say, 'David earnestly leave of me, that he might run to Bethlehem his city, for there is an yearly sacrifice there for all the family.' If he says thus, it is well, thy servant shall have peace. But if he is wroth, then be sure that evil is determined by him. Therefore thou shalt deal kindly unto thy servant, for thou hast brought thy servant into the covenant of the Lord with thee. Notwithstanding, if there be any iniquity, slay me thyself. Why shouldst thou bring me to thy father?" And Jonathan said, "Far be it from thee. For I knew certainly that evil was determined by my father to come upon thee. Then would I not tell thee?" Then said Jonathan to David to Jonathan, "Who shall tell me? Or what if thy father answer thee roughly?" And Jonathan said unto David, "Come, let us go into the field." And they went both of them into the field. And Jonathan said unto David, "O Lord, God of Israel, when I have sounded my father about tomorrow any time, and on third day, and behold, if there be any good toward David, I then send not unto thee and show it unto thee. And the Lord do so, and much more to Jonathan. But if it please my father to do thee evil, then I will show it to thee, and send thee away, that thou might go in peace. And the Lord be with thee as he has been with my father. Thou shalt not really, while I yet live, show me the kindness of the Lord, that I die not. But also thou shalt not cut off thy kindness from my house forever. No, when the Lord has cut off the enemies of David, every one from the face of the earth." And Jonathan made a covenant with the house of the Lord, saying, "Let the Lord require it at the hand of David's enemies." And Jonathan caused David to swear again, because he loved him, for he loved him as he loved his own soul. And Jonathan said to David, "Tomorrow is a new moon. Thou shalt be missed, because the seat will be empty. And when thou hast stayed 3 days, then thou shalt go down quickly, and come to the place where thou dost hide thyself with thy business was in hand. And there shall remain by the stone Ezel. And I will shoot three arrows on the side thereof, as though I shot at a mark. And behold, I will send a lad, saying, 'Go find out the arrows.' If I expressly say unto the lad, 'Behold, the arrows are on the side of thee, take them,' then come thou, for there is peace today, and no hurt as the Lord liveth. But if I say thus to the Lord, 'Behold, the arrows are beyond thee, go thy way, because the Lord has sent thee away. And as touching the matter which thou hast said, and I have spoken of, behold, the Lord be between thee and me forever.'" So David hid himself in the field, and when the new moon was come, the king sat down to eat meat. And the king sat upon his seat, as other times, even upon a seat by the wall. And Jonathan arose, and Abner sat by Saul's side, and David's place was empty. Nevertheless, Saul spake not anything that day, for he thought, something has befallen him. He is not clean, surely he is not clean. Came to pass on the morrow, which was the second day of the month, that David's place was empty. And Saul said unto Jonathan, his son, wherefore cometh not the son of Jesse to meet, neither yesterday nor today? And Jonathan answered Saul, David earnestly asked leave of me to go to Bethlehem. And he said, let me go, I pray thee, for our family has a sacrifice in the city, and my brother, he has commanded me to be there. And now, if I have found favor in thy eyes, let me get away, I pray thee, and see my brother. And therefore he cometh not to the king's table. And Saul's anger was kindled against Jonathan. And he said unto him, thou son of the perverse, rebellious woman, do not I know that thou hast chosen the son of Jesse to thine own confusion, unto the confusion of thy mother's nakedness? For as long as the son of Jesse liveth upon the ground, thou shalt not be established nor thy kingdom. Wherefore now send and fetch him unto me, for he shall surely die. And Jonathan answered Saul his father and said unto him, wherefore shall he be slain? What has he done? And Saul cast a javelin at him to smite him, whereby Jonathan knew that it was determined of his father to slay David. And so Jonathan arose from the table in fierce anger, and did eat no meat the second day of the month, for he was grieved for David, because his father had done in shame. And it came to pass in the morning that Jonathan went out into the field at the time appointed with God, and the little lad was with him. And he said unto this lad, run, find now the arrows which I shoot. The lad ran, behold, he shot an arrow beyond him. When the lad was come to the place of the arrow that Jonathan had shot, Jonathan cried after the lad and said, is not the arrow beyond you? And Jonathan cried after the lad, make speed, haste, no, stay not. And Jonathan's lad gathered up the arrows and came to his master. But the lad knew not anything. Only Jonathan and David knew the matter. And Jonathan gave his artillery upon his lad and said unto him, go carry them to the city. And as soon as the lad was gone, David arose out of the place towards the south and fell on his face to the ground, bowed himself three times, and they kissed one another and wept with one another. And David exceeded. And Jonathan said to David, go in peace, for as much as we have sown, both of us in the name of the Lord, say, the Lord be between me and thee, and between thy seed and my seed forever. And he arose and departed, and Jonathan went into the city.